This guy is so jacked, he's even got his own book, which I may well be sharing tips from. I mean, it's been ripped for ages, but not since day one.
They all think that celebrities pop out of the womb ripped.
When filming Magic Mike, director Steven Soderbergh said, "It's incredible what kind of shape he's in." The joke on the set was he was walking CGI.
You've got this kind of leg right there.
Get into that Joe Manganiello workout, and when prepping for True Blood, Joe Manganiello dropped 20 pounds of body fat and increased every single muscle measurement in just 8 weeks. It was a lot of sets and a lot of reps. His personal trainer, Ron Matthews, told him it's all about cardio, 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 intensity, intensity, intensity.
I work out twice a day, 6 days a week when I'm training for a shoot like today, or for True Blood or Magic Mike or any other project that I have. So it's a lot.
He literally does every exercise there is, by the way. Like, name an exercise Joe Manganiello doesn't do in the comments. Thought so. We're talking dumbbell bench press, dumbbell incline press, barbell incline press, pec deck, dumbbell flies, close grip barbell bench press, dips, cable chest flies, push-ups, lat pull down. The list goes on. Listen, in his book, he says, "The lighter the weight and more cardio I did, the better I would end up looking." Going on to say, "No matter how heavy I lifted, the moment I took my shirt off, the results were just not what I wanted."
It's a lot of hard work. I'd love to roll out of bed and, you know, not have to do anything, but yeah, it's a lot of work.
In his book, he tells you to drop the weight, drop the ego, and watch your body transform.
It's more of a lifestyle. It's not what you can do in 12 weeks, it's what you can do in a year from now to change your body and therefore change your life.
He says, working at a moderate weight and learn how to completely turn on that muscle fiber is more beneficial than just stacking a bar with weight and putting tension on your ligaments and joints to control the movement. The goal is to squeeze your muscles during each movement and for every rep to be controlled and felt in your muscles through a full range of motion. And for that to happen, you need to drop the weight. Check your ego, lower the weight, and let your body grow. Create that mind-muscle connection first and then increase the weight. He quotes Arnold Schwarzenegger when he said, "Resistance is resistance is resistance." That's why my program works so well too. Link in the description, by the way.
My training's evolved a lot. When I was cast on True Blood, my body was not very cut. So I spent the first year raising the intensity level, not taking rest in between sets, lowering the weight to make sure that the form was correct. This past season, I got into powerlifting and got into the traditional Olympic lifts.
Let's get into his cardio. Cardio was 3 to 6 times per week, often early morning slow cardio for 45 minutes on the elliptical whilst fasted.
The idea is to lump a lot of clay on and then carve it down. Really heavy cardio, 2 workouts a day, 6 days a week, plus a very strict diet. My training style has evolved into, basically it's like CrossFit for a professional football player.
Wow.
So it's a lot of like 1950s, you know, Russian powerlifting techniques. A lot of things that get into, you know, a clock and a timer and really pushing your heart rate up. So that I get a, you know, crazy cardio workout while I'm moving big weights around.
Let's get into that Joe Manganiello diet. And when it comes to food, you know, he's got a catchphrase.
I always say I eat to build.
In his Evolution book, he expands on this eat to build mindset, saying, "I think of training in terms of construction. When I work out, I'm building a house, and the food I eat is raw material, the bricks that ensure the house is built solid." Along with drinking 3 liters of water a day, key foods Joe Manganiello has in his diet are, for protein, it's steak, chicken breast, pork, ham, shrimp, eggs, and Greek yogurt. For fats, almonds, pistachios, cashews, and PB2 peanut butter. Carbs, it was oatmeal and sweet potatoes. Vegetables, spinach, carrots, celery, tomatoes, cucumber, and green onions. And for fruit, strawberries, blueberries, and apples.
If you want to put on empty weight, eat empty food. So, you know, I work out really hard in the gym and I eat a lot of protein in order to provide me with the building blocks to maximize that training. So there's no sugar, no carbs, no alcohol. So you have to cut out a lot of that fun, delicious stuff that most people really like. My diet is very strict, but not strict in a way that it's not fun. I'm a carnivore. So I get to eat as much meat as I can pretty much put down. I'm not somebody that's against fat. I'm against sugar. I think sugar when you're training is the number one killer. You gotta get rid of the sugar, get rid of the bread. I work out specifically to different roles. And when it isn't a role that I have to be in a certain type of shape for, I mean, I eat everything in sight. Well, I'm looking at these dishes. There's a lot of fried chicken here. Fried chicken and waffles is probably my go-to guilty pleasure dish. Jelly beans.
I saw you have an ice cream station here, and I was over there dipping into the jelly bellies.
Right, let's get into Joe Manganiello's supplements, which reminds me.
I'm completely natural. No steroids, no human growth hormones, ever.
So his supplements are caffeine, whey protein, protein bars, creatine, glutamine, and nitric oxide-releasing supplements.
I've never touched a steroid or a human growth hormone. That's just not the type of life experience that I was interested in having. I wanted to see what I could do naturally. And this book and this workout program and my story as contained in the book are a record of that. And it's my experience. You can do it cleanly. You know, you don't have to look at the screen and point and go, that guy's on, you know, that guy did this or did that, and I can't do that. That's not possible for me. What I'm saying is that look at that before picture. It's possible for anybody. If I could transform from that skinny kid who couldn't do one pull-up into the guy who's on the cover, anybody can do it.
I did this completely naturally, no steroids, no human growth hormones. I was not born genetically to put on muscle. I was cursed with long limbs.
Let's get into Joe Manganiello's rules. He's got rules, 11 rules to get ripped. Rule one, always have 3 big meals per day. Rule two, fill hunger gaps with small snacks that include protein. Rule three, protein at all meals. Rule four, kiss sugar goodbye. Rule five, drop the alcohol. Rule six, eat fiber from various sources like nuts, fruits, vegetables, berries, and legumes. Rule seven, vegetables at every meal. Rule eight, don't avoid foods that include saturated fat, such as fish, beef, pork, and eggs. Rule nine, drink 3 liters of water per day. Rule 10, limit carbs to natural sources, such as sweet potatoes. And rule 11, when not preparing for an event, enjoy 3 cheat meals per week.
The real enemy is the mind, not the body.
With the technology level increase, there's going to be increased stress levels. Keeping fit, nutrition was going to be incredibly important for the human race as we move on. You know, without being in the kind of shape that I am physically, I couldn't be in the kind of shape that I am mentally.
Look, if you want to get ripped like a Hollywood movie star, get on the program. Link in the description.